reading from the book of Tom. Welcome, friends. Welcome once again to the Atheist, Agnostic, Humanist, Realist, Old Time, Downtime, Gospel Hour. Can I get an amen?
Amen!
So save me all.
You know what? That's a little bit too specific to one religion. Let's do something, a little few different things. All the men, can I get an all right?
All right!
All the women, can I get an oh yeah?
Oh yeah!
Just the sound guy, can I get an okay?
Okay!
Thank you very much. My friends, I am here to bring you the good news. The good news that this is a beautiful and dangerous and mysterious world we live in. That there's a lot we don't know. There's just a lot we don't know. A lot we may never know. There may be a heaven. There may be a hell. There may be a devil. There may be a God. But there ain't no proof. No hardcore science. No roadmap to the stars, to the pearly gates. No interview with Gabriel and Hot Archangels Monthly. We've got to take it all on faith. And that's just a little difficult for some of us. You hear about free will. You hear about making your own choice. And you'd like just a little bit of proof. And at some point you realize there may not be proof a coming. And at that point you realize there may not be a heaven. There may not be a hell. There may not be a devil. There may not be a God. And you say to yourself, well, what am I doing here? If there ain't a God, what am I doing here?
What are you doing here?
What is my purpose in life? And I am here to tell you that your purpose in life is exactly the same either way. If there's a God, your purpose is to live, to help people, and to make the world a better place. And if there's not a God, your purpose is to live, to help people, to make the world a better place. Now, I know that some of you out there want there to be a God for a very different reason. Because you feel alone. Because without God, it's a big, bad, scary, random universe out there. So let me tell you right now, it's a big, bad, scary, random universe out there with God. Bad stuff happens. Good stuff happens. Stuff happens. If it doesn't happen, you're dead. But here's the important part. This is truly the really, really important part. This is it, everybody. You are not alone. You are not alone. You've got a family of 6 billion right here with you. I'd even go so far as to say, we got a family of 200 right here in this room. You think they don't know your troubles? You think they don't know your heart? They know yours as well as they know their own. You think the world ain't a scary place for them? It's a scary place for everybody. But it's also a fantastically beautiful place. And it's the only place we know for sure that we've got. So it is our duty, our purpose in life, our reason to be, to make this the best of all possible worlds. Let me tell ya. God made the world, so they say, and he did it in only 7 days. But they can't tell you if those days were short or long. And they think their God is threatened if the dates are wrong. God made Adam.
God made Adam.
God made Eve.
God made Eve.
Kicked them out of Eden because they were deceived.
Yes, that's it.
They had children. One was good, one scum. Cain killed Abel, then got married. Where'd his wife come from? There's all these little problems where the story doesn't jive. If God created all of us, why single out one tribe? Why weren't there any dinosaurs on Noah's floating zoo? Why tell us all these fairy tales when we got stuff to do? We got the world, here and now. Things happen, it's only natural to ask how. But there's no reason to trust mythology. The world right here and now's enough for me. Yeah. God made commandments. God made rules. He said to build a better life, these are the tools. He said the first four are to worship me. If you don't, you will be tortured for eternity. But what if this world, is all there is? Oh, what if when you die, there ain't no final quiz? No hell or heaven. Well, that's all right with me. We'll make it heaven here on earth. Just wait and see. Why punish us forever for an arbitrary rule? Why set us up for failure? Does God have to be so cruel? Why give us all these instincts for committing moral sins? Why give us all these ways to lose before the game begins? We got the world, the here and now. There may be nothing out of here or the town, but I got present responsibility. The world right here and now's enough for me. Oh,
we got the world,
the here and now, and you know we're gonna make it somehow. But I ain't counting on eternity. The world right here and now's enough for me. Who out there needs to be healed? Well, get some Obamacare. It'll take care of you. You'll be fine. There may be a God, and there may not. The world we're living in just might be all we got. That ain't no problem, 'cause whether spawned or made, the only way to live is not to be afraid. We've got our minds, we've got our hearts, we got our souls, and they're the most important parts. We don't need threatening to tell what's right from wrong. Just mind your business, clean things up, and get along. The world is filled with wonderment and beauty near and far, and trying to understand it is just being who we are. If there's a God, he told us that the world he made was ours. We're almost done exploring here. The next stop is the stars. We got the world,
the here and now.
And we're gonna reach up to those heavens somehow. It's up to us to fulfill our destiny. The world right here and now's enough for me. Oh yeah, I got the world,
the
here and now. And you know we're gonna make it somehow. Find God within you, the rest comes naturally. The world right here and now's enough for me. Ladies and gentlemen.